right now, if you purchase the Magnum sprayer, you get your 7.5 meters worth of hose, you get your spray gun, you get a tip and a spray guard standard with the pack. With any of ours, through Go and through Tint, you get an exclusive offer, which is always pretty cool. You get a 40 centimeter tip extension, which is gonna be perfect for hitting those gutters. I don't need to be too close and I can get the angles that I want. You're going to get a spray guard with that, that are going to be able to run fine finish low pressure tips, which you'll get two of these. You're gonna get a 514 and a 312. And I'll explain what those numbers mean in a second. But first, let's get it set up. If I was just gonna run no tip extension on the gun, I'm gonna screw my spray guard straight onto the gun, put my tip in, that's fine. But I'm gonna be using my 40 centimeter tip extension. So I just thread my spray guard on, it screws in nicely. This can just be hand tight on this section here, that's fine. Spray gun. Your guard will screw straight onto that. Now, very important, with your same shifter, I always nick this one a little bit tighter than hand tight, because there is a seal in there, and if you don't do it tight enough, you will feel a little bit of paint starting to come out of that thread. You don't want to paint your hand, you want to paint the gutter. So that's on, I've just nicked it very tightly, or not too tightly with a wrench. This only needs to be hand tight because I can actually change the direction of spray with the guard itself. We're all good. So let's move on to tip sizes. This is a fine finish, low pressure, 310 or a 310 tip. So your first number of your spray tips is your fan width. So we take the three, we double it, it's six. It's gonna be a 6-inch fan because all Graco products are US, it's an Imperial, I'm sorry for that. On our website, we have a spray tip chart conversion from inches to millimeters, so you know what fan that is. But this is the 6-inch fan. The next two numbers is the size of the orifice in thousandths of an inch. Again, that probably doesn't mean too much to you, but we've got a sprayer lookup table where what material equals what tip size. For all Tint products, we've put in the hard work for you, we've done our testing, we've got a sheet of recommendations. So right now for gutters, with Tint's exterior product, I'm going to be spraying with a 310, or I might change to a 312, depending on how I get this dialed in. Again, it's letting in a little bit less paint than say a tip that I was using inside the 514 for the walls. And that's because I need a bit more control. I'm gonna be doing two, maybe three coats, and I don't wanna put out as much product and risk sags or runs on my gutters because it is a pain to get up there and to lightly sand it. So again, I'd rather do an extra coat, put a little bit less product on and have a bit more control. Right now is an instruction guide on how it works, which I'll explain to you. So meh, don't need that. Our actual spray tip, we have a spare, what we call a one seal, which is fits into your spray guard. They are smaller for fine finish low pressure tips, which we'll need to change out. And this yellow hot solvent seal. Keep this aside, we will not be using this. We will not be spraying solvents through a Magnum sprayer. They're not compatible. Boom, aside, goodbye. This is important. So with our spray guard, let's get this right here. As it comes standard out of the kit, we have a one seal in there that you can see is a lot bigger of a hole than what's with our fine finish low pressure one seal. This is a gasket that tightens as we screw it back against this tip extension or the spray gun. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna poke this little guy out. This is also really important for cleaning because over time when we get paint running through, the back of this rubber seal here can get a bit of paint film on it and can cause spitting. So let's make sure that's nice and clean. Flathead screwdriver, a pen, a pencil, just to poke that little guy through. I'm gonna edge that out. Yeah. There we go. So I've just pushed that through there. It comes out by pushing it through the top. We've got a separate video on how to do this. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the correct one seal with my fine finish low pressure tip. I'm gonna put it on the end of my tip there. It seats in really nicely. I'm gonna poke it through the guard here. I'm gonna make sure that's gonna line up there with where I fit my spray tip into. And I'm going to eyeball that. And it's gonna go in only one way. It'll only go in one way. And we need to make sure that's in nice and secure. So we poke it through with your finger at the back. Make sure it's seating nicely, happy days. How do I put in a spray tip? You'll see that it's machined here with a little lip, fits in this groove there sideways. That's how a spray tip goes in. You'll know if it's in properly because it'll be nice and secure. And when we change the tip direction, it's gonna be nice and tight. So again, let's spray this onto the, let's secure this onto the end of our tip extension. This only needs to be hand tight. Screws on, perfect. So my 310 tip, got my spray guard on, connected to the gun, my gun filter's back in, we're ready to dial in the spray fan with our pressure.